Oh, I'm so tired. I just want to show something. So here I have four versions of Theo Duck's Hopeless Romantic. So starting from the top, we have the original from the source file, export from FamTracker. I think this time I used DN FamTracker. One of the newest versions. Second row, we have an export through NSF Play, which is not the best, and it runs at 60 hertz. I think this time I didn't export from FamTracker to NSF. I think I might have used the Field Duck's export version, which is actually pretty buggy, but it's not as buggy as the early Family Trackers, where if you export it, NSF Play will just kind of shit itself and will play at like one quarter speed until it can catch up. Anyway, I didn't export the entire thing. I only export like a minute of it, or 30 seconds. This is pretty laggy, so I'm going to not draw the spectrum of the ones I'm not gonna be playing. So anyway, let me just get this out of the way first. So this there isn't something about something annoying about this when I was doing it, trying to line them and stuff, is C-Trix version here in the third row uses 141 beats per minute instead of 140. The source file uses 280, divides nicely because there's a double precision in original Family Tracker tracker. Honestly, I didn't know this performance even existed until probably about 2 months ago when I started, like after I already started doing this transcription, and I actually liked it so much I actually added Ctrix's like an intro into it. So yeah, this is kind of what it sounds like. For most part, it is still mostly an original near 1-to-1 ratio. Not exactly. There's a lot of like these triplets aren't exact in time, and I did simplify those things a lot. There's a lot of limitations of musical anyway. So that aside, let me just close this. I might as well close this now, actually. Yes, yeah, so I'll let you listen to some comparisons between two. First two, I'll go between. Let me just disable this one. Waveform, spectrum. I'll mute these two. Oops. My computer's not liking you right now. Anyway, something I've noticed that these are actually still desynced, so you'll see. So on the left, I have 60 hertz, the Famicom. On the right speaker, I have the original. As you can see, there was a bit of a weird desync somewhere around here. I think it's like NSF players just not able to keep up with their demand. So I noticed NSF play, like, I don't know how like NSF export works when your engine rate doesn't match an original Famicom. But some tracks, like, what's it called? FDX by RushJet, which runs at like 400 hertz. It gets a bit weird and finicky when you like slow it down and speed back up. You notice like the track doesn't line up, but like for some reason it still stays in tune. And you can verify that using by exporting it to WAV format. And it's just really fucking weird because visually it looks like it's gotta be fucking random. You play in slow motion, it is fucking random, but when you speed back up, I was like, hang on a second, how does this work? Anyway, so getting rid of that one, I'll show my this is my one that I've been working on. I have this, just so you know, this is not synced up directly to it's only synced up to the first beat. The reason why this one be split, you'll notice, is because Ctrix's adaption is also, like, on top of having that 141 beats per minute, which I actually did fix. Yeah, I just slightly scaled it. It took like, I think, 9 minutes of processing time because the computer isn't that fast. And I split the audio bit here somewhere. Yeah, I split it here. Anyway, well, actually, no, I did. Maybe I might have put them together. I forgot to do that. Anyway, so here's what it sounds like. Left speaker, my piano transcription. Right speaker, his original. Not sure why my computer pooped out there for a bit, but anyway, so let's go on to Ctrix's version. I'm just gonna put this away from view. Mute my one. Left side Ctrix, right side original. And I'll show you what happened. What was I gonna do? So the changes I've done to my transcription is well, I'll try to include Citrix's intro just to, you know, but I probably won't be extending the part that's missing here in the middle because I don't really know how to replicate in MuseCore very well. Because so my goals with the transcription, that it needs to be played back with MuseCore's default sound font and must sound good and be as close as possible to original as much as possible. But yeah, really the only major change that I added was copy and paste a bunch of rhythms, so mostly from the first bar of the intro of Field of Dark's original, and then I added Citrix's solo to it, transcribed via, of course. It sounds like something like this. Actually, might as well just play all of them all together. Yeah. Sounds pretty nice, actually, I reckon. Say you can really notice so with the spectrum analyzer, so if I zoom in onto the original, you'll see it starts off with a vibrato, gets chaotic, and then it kind of splits into the three beams, and then it goes chaotic again as it progresses up. These vertical lines is because that's just how the fast Fourier transform tries to do it in fucking Audacity, and in the way Citrix does it, he also has a vibrato effect, and then he kind of just like does an arpeggio thing, as you can see. Something you also notice, Citrix, when he makes his tune, he likes to use octaves a bit, quite a fair bit, although it could just be it could just be this, the Fourier transform just showing the harmonics, because X square waves have harmonics and octaves. Anyway, so the way I've done it, this thing would finish loading. Where is it? Oh, here it is. Is that I start with a vibrato, and then I kind of just like split it into like a, what you call it, was it, they call it tremolo, and then I so it's just like a very fast arpeggio in between the max and bottom notes, the top and bottom notes. I can't insert the middle note. Oh, I get the technique can, but you know, the music sheet's already messy enough as this, and it sounds good enough, which is why I kept it like this, you know. So let me just unpin it. It's like, it's not perfect, but it gets the job done. So as you can see, Citrix kind of just gives up halfway here. But I think that's just him extending it out. So like he really did extend out this little instrumental section by quite a fair bit, as you can see. Actually, rather than re-rendering it, I'll just show you the original again. So, music, family, FOD. How to describe it, but basically to me it's a bit more dirty, and I guess it has a grunting like kind of like sound to it in the Family Tracker version. Sorry, not Family Tracker, the Famicom export version. But yeah, actually I might show you that FDX thing while I'm here. You can see the pattern in the FDS channel changes as I slow it down and speed it up, which is really weird. It's like there's a term for it. We can have infinite repeating patterns that cost almost no computational power. So look at this. This sounds nothing like it, like it actually looks like. Anyway. I just thought I'd give that I thought I'd just show that. Anyway. That's it for this video. Yeah, it's pretty trashy, but there you go. So I just wanted to get this out.